All right. I'm going to write the title more here. All right. So remember that we were seeing the present continuous, right? El día de ayer estábamos viendo el presente continuo. Vamos a terminar este plan de hoy, as we are going to finish this PDF, and we are going to continue with the second part. Y vamos a continuar con la segunda parte. Vamos a recordar un poco la estructura. We are going to remember the structure. First, we have the pronouns, yes? Primero tenemos los pronombres, pronouns. Then, we have the verb to be conjugated. Segundo, tenemos el verbo to be conjugado, verb to be conjugated. And finally, we have the verb, tenemos el verbo en su forma de ing, working in this case, yes, working. So, say, I am working, you are working, he is working, she is working, it is working, we are working, they are working. Yes, the clue is to remember the verb to be. La clave realmente es recordar la conjugación del verbo to be y las reglas en las que debemos cambiar, digamos acá, la estructura del verbo para añadirle el ing al final, yes? So, we're going to continue over here, wait a second, we already did these exercises, ya hicimos estos ejercicios, vamos a continuar con, what is this? Okay, right here. So, remember that we were seeing these verbs over here, clean, sleep, read, drive, write, dance, call, play. We have eat and cook. Yes? You're going to remember these verbs because with these ones we are going to do an activity. Yes? Vamos a recordar estos verbos porque vamos a hacer unas actividades con ellos. Ahora, recordemos entonces la regla de los verbos que terminan en E. Drive, write, dance. Son verbos que terminan en E. Al momento de yo volverlos en presente continuo, debo eliminar la E. Entonces me quedaría, wait a second, drive, driving, write, writing, dance, dancing. Yes, I have to erase the E at the end. Tengo que eliminar la E para poder adjuntar ing, ing, ing. ¿Ok? Con el resto de verbos no pasa nada, simplemente les añado ing. ¿Sí? Porque no tengo que seguir esta regla, no terminan en E. So, eat, call, play, sleep, read, cook, clean. All of them are going to add the ing. Eating, calling, playing, sleeping, reading, cooking, cleaning. Yes? And questions, doubts? Until here? Do you have questions or doubts?
Oh, teacher, thanks.
Okay. So, we continue. This part. We continue over here. So, we have this example. The teacher is teaching present continuous. And we have these exercises over here. So, Sebas, what is the correct verb here? The gear is?
Is playing.
Very good. The girl is playing soccer. Playing, ing. Yes, remember, ing. Very good. Wait a second, I'm going to change the color. We continue. Here, the chicken is... Hello, Rosalba, how are you?
Hello.
All right, you're going to help me. Sorry?
Ah, okay.
The chicken. You're going to help me with this one, yes? The chicken is?
Okay, the chicken is dancing rock and roll.
Perfect. The chicken is dancing rock and roll. Very good. Thank you. We continue with this one, Sebas. Snoopy is...
reading.
Very good. Snoopy is reading a book. Perfect. Thank you, Sebas. We continue here. Rosalba, the chef is... ay, se nos fue Rosalba la conexión. All right. So, Sebas, what is the correct answer here? The chef is...
cooking.
Very good. The chef is cooking the dinner. How do you say dinner in Spanish?
Cena.
Cena. Very good. Thank you. We continue here. Emily is the house. Hello, Rose. You're back. Yes. What is the correct answer?
Emily is cleaning the house.
That's so cleaning. Yes.
Cleaning.
Emily is cleaning the house. Very good. Thank you. We continue here, Sebas. Mr. John is
driving.
Very good. Mr. John is driving a sports car. Sports car. Perfect. We continue here. Rose, the students are the homework.
The students are studying the homework?
Well, we can say studying.
Doing?
Ah, yes. We can say doing. It's more appropriate. Yes, doing. The students are doing the homework. Very good. Perfect. Thank you. We continue here with Sebas. The mouse is
eating.
Very good. The mouse is eating carrots. Eating carrots. Very good. We continue here. Now we are going to do some sentences. Yes? So we have watch, wait, help, study, and sit. We have these verbs, yes? We are going to make sentences. Vamos a hacer oraciones con estos verbos. So, for example, number one, watch. I can say, she is watching TV. She is watching TV, yes? Number two, wait. Rose, can you make a sentence with the verb wait in the present continuous?
I'm waiting for you.
Very good. I'm waiting for you. Yes, very good. Wait es el verbo esperar. Yes, I'm waiting for you. Very good. We continue. Sebas, can you make a sentence with the verb help in the present continuous?
I am helping for friends.
I am helping my friend. Yes. I'm helping my friend. Yes, very good. I am helping my friend. Thank you, Sebas. We continue, Rose. Study. Can you make a sentence in the present continuous with the verb study?
He is studying the lesson.
Very good. He's studying the lesson. Perfect. Here we have the verb sit. Sit. What is sit in Spanish? How do you say sit in Spanish?
Sentarse.
Sentarse. Yes, very good. So, Sebas, can you make a sentence with the verb sit in the present continuous?
I am sitting
in the chair, maybe. Yes. In the chair, en la silla. Yes, me estoy sentando en la silla. I'm sitting in the chair. All right, we are going to continue. Very good. You have a very good imagination to make sentences. All right. Now look, we have this exercise. This is the last exercise of the PDF. I need to put it kind of bigger. Okay, so look. Form sentences in the present continuous tense. Recuerden que tense significa tiempo, ¿sí? Pero hace referencia a un tiempo gramatical. Gramatical. ¿Qué es esto? Lo que estamos viendo. En este caso, el presente continuo, ¿sí? Tense, tense. All right, so look. Example. Here we have I slash watch slash TV. We are going to make a sentence using these words, but we are going to conjugate the verb in the appropriate form. Yes? Vamos a conjugar el verbo en la forma apropiada para construir con estas tres palabras una oración en present continuous. En este caso, la oración nos quedaría así. I'm watching TV. Yes? So, for example, number one, bueno, la número uno tiene un error. No es hair, no es hair, es chair. Chair, que quiere decir silla, ¿sí? Entonces yo digo, I am sitting on a chair. On a chair, ¿yes? Chicos, recuerden, sit es un verbo de una sola sílaba, por lo tanto debemos doblar la última consonante. Sitting, sitting. Okay, I'm sitting on a chair. Number two, Rose, please. He smoked a cigar.
He is smoking a cigar.
Very good. Very good. He is smoking a cigar. Now, number three, Sebas.
They are playing football.
Perfect. They are playing football. Thank you. Number four, Rose.
It is raining.
Very good. It is raining. It's raining. Students, how do you say this in Spanish? It is raining in Spanish.
Está lloviendo.
Very good. It is raining. Now, how do we make questions with this one? Rose, do you live in Barranquilla, right?
Yes.
So, is it raining in Barranquilla in this moment?
No. Right now. Right now?
It is not raining right now. Yes, no, it is not raining right now. Okay, very good. Sebas, is it raining in Buenos Aires? Is it raining in Buenos Aires, Sebas?
No. Hay un poco de nubes, pero no.
Okay, so, no, it is not raining. Raining right now. We can say there are some clouds. Hay algunas nubes, yes? There are some clouds. All right, very good. Well, we're going to continue. I'm going to raise this or here. Or here. Well, I live in Manizales, you know, in Manizales, Colombia. And here it is not raining either. It is not raining in Manizales. Well, we continue with number five, Sebas. And
Anne is writing a letter.
Remember, write es un verbo que termina en e. Para yo volverlo presente continuo, debo eliminar la e y adjuntar ing. Yes, remember that. Students, letter. Esto puede significar letra, ¿sí? Puede significar letra o puede significar carta, ¿sí? Tiene dos opciones. Letter puede significar letra o carta, ¿yes? Anne is writing a letter. En este caso, Anne está escribiendo una carta, ¿yes? All right, we continue. Number six, Rose, please.
Bob is reading a book.
Very good. Bob is reading a book. Perfect. Number seven, Sebas.
We walking to work.
We are walking to work. It's very good. Remember the verb to be? Yes, remember the verb to be. We are walking to work. Este verbo se pronuncia de una manera particular. No vamos a pronunciar la L y la A va a sonar como una O. Entonces lo pronunciaríamos walking, walking. We are walking to work. Yes, walking. All right. We continue. Number 8, Rose, please.
You are eating an apple.
You are eating an apple. You are eating an apple. Very good. Number 9, Sebas.
They are running around.
Yes, very good. They are running around the park. They are running around the park. Remember, running, double N, yes, doble N, porque es un verbo de una sola sílaba en donde debemos doblar la última consonante al volverlo presente continuo, present continuous, yes. And finally, number 10, I wait for the bus. Rose, please.
I'm waiting for the bus.
I'm waiting for the bus. Very good. Okay, students, do you have questions, doubts?
No, teacher, thanks.
Okay, so we continue with the second part of the present continuous. I'm going to share the screen over here. Wait a minute. Okay. Present continuous, second part. Okay, students, are you seeing the other PDF? Yes?
Yes.
Okay, perfect. So, fill in the blanks with. Vamos a llenar los espacios con is or are. Yes? Just two options. Right. Just two options. Okay? Is or are. So, number one, Rose, please. Kate.
Kate is cooking a turkey for dinner.
Very good. Kate is cooking a turkey for dinner. Students, how do you say turkey in Spanish? You know turkey?
Pavo, no es?
Pavo, yes. You're right. Sebas, do you like turkey?
No, nunca
no,
comí.
Like. Oh, you haven't tried, no lo has probado. Maybe.
No.
Okay, so we can say, I haven't tried turkey. Yes, no he probado el pavo. Yes. And Rose, do you like turkey?
Yes, I like turkey.
I like turkey too. I like turkey. That's good. Well, we continue. Number two, Sebas. Mom.
Is sitting the table.
Very good. Mom is setting the table. Yes. Setting the table. Esto es organizar el comedor y organizar la mesa para comer. Setting the table means organizarlo. Como tal, poner los platos, las cucharas, ¿sí? Kind of that. All right, we continue. Number three, Rose, please.
John is making coffee.
Coffee, very good. Thank you. Number four, Sebas, the boys
are watching TV.
Are watching TV. Very good. Number five, Rose, it.
Excuse me. It is snowing Outside.
Very good. It is snowing outside. Students, how do you say snowing in Spanish?
Nevando.
Yes, very good. Nevando. And outside, how do you say outside in Spanish?
Afuera.
Afuera, very good. El contrario de outside, the contrary of outside is inside. Inside, adentro. Outside, afuera, inside, adentro. Okay, we continue with number six. Sebas, please, the baby.
Is laughing.
Very good. The baby is laughing. Esta G con H se va a pronunciar muy particular. La vamos a pronunciar como si fuera una F. Laughing. The baby is laughing. Laughing quiere decir reírse, pero reírse a carcajadas. Yes, laughing. The baby is laughing. All right, we continue. Number seven, Rose, please. The gears.
The gears are painting Easter eggs.
Very good. The gears are painting Easter eggs. Do you remember Easter? ¿Recuerdan Easter? What is this in Spanish?
Pascua.
Pascua. Very good. In this case, that is huevos de Pascua. Yes, Easter eggs, huevos de Pascua. Okay, we continue with Sebas, number eight.
Daniela, disculpa, una pregunta. Cada vez que encuentre una G con la H, suena como F. Fin.
No, no, o sea, cada vez que casos. En este particularmente, vamos a pronunciarlo como una F. En este particularmente, pero no en todos los casos.
Ok.
Ok, we continue. Number eight, Sebas.
We are 18 Turkey.
We are eating turkey. Yes. Eating turkey. Very good. Rose number nine. The dog.
The dog is barking.
The dog is barking. Yes. Look. Barking. What is this? How do you say barking in Spanish?
Ladrar.
Very good, yes. El perro está ladrando. Yes, ladrando. All right, and finally, number 10, Sebas.
They are celebrating Easter.
Yes, they are celebrating Easter. Very good. Okay, we continue. I'm going to raise this part. We are going to continue with this game, yes? You are going to choose the right option, yes? Choose the right option. So, question number one, look. Mr. Smith is, and we have three options. Mr. Smith is jumping, Mr. Smith is walking, Mr. Smith is dancing. Rose, what is the correct answer?
Walking.
Walking, very good. Mr. Smith is walking. Yes.
Okay.
Thank you. We continue, Sebas. The mice. Recordemos que mice, esto significa ratones en plural. Porque para decir un solo ratón, yo digo mouse. Mouse hace referencia a un solo ratón, solo uno. Pero si yo quiero decir ratones en plural, yo digo mice. So, the mice are, Sebas, what is the correct option? Look at the image. You have to analyze the image.
The mice are drawing.
Drawing, very good. The mice are drawing, yes. We continue here, Rose. Mr. Johnson is...
Mr. Johnson is smoking.
Smoking, very good. Mr. Johnson is smoking. Perfect. We continue here. John is, Sebas, what is the correct option?
John is crying.
Crying, very good. John is crying. Or here, crying. We continue here. They are, Rose, they are.
They are dancing.
Dancing, very good. They are dancing. We continue. Jack is, Sebas, what is the correct option?
Eating.
Very good. Jack is eating. Hi. We continue here. The bears are, Rose, what is the correct option?
The bears are flying.
Are flying. Yes, very good. The bears are flying. We continue here. The dog is, Sebas.
The dog is running.
Very good. The dog is running. Running.
My dog is sleeping.
Is sleeping in this moment?
Yes.
That's so cute. What is the name of your dog, Sebas?
Your name is Tuco.
Tuco. Ah, yes, I remember. That's good. All right. We continue here. Rose, Jack is?
Jack is having a bath.
Very good. Jack is having a bath. Having a bath. Remember, si él estuviera en la ducha, entonces diríamos having a shower. En la ducha, having a shower. Como está en una bañera, having a bath. Right? We continue here. Sebas, Peter is
arriving.
Very good. Peter is arriving. Peter is arriving. Yes. All right. We continue. Rose, Mr. Smith is.
Mr. Smith is hunting.
Hunting. Very good. Mr. Smith is hunting. Yes. And how do you say hunting in Spanish?
Cazar.
Cazando. Yes.
Cazando.
Yes. Very good. We continue here. Sebas. Mr. Wolf is.
Is cycling.
Very good. Mr. Wolf is cycling. Yes. Cycling. We continue here. Well, this is a question for Rose. Yes. The children are the bus.
The children are getting off the bus.
Very good. Getting off the bus. Bueno, la imagen no está muy clara. Como es una presentación que se volvió PDF, yo creo que tenía movimiento. Get off, el verbo get off, significa bajarse. Right? Get off, bajarse. En este caso, bajarse del bus. Yes? Getting off. Los muñequitos están como mirando hacia el bus, pero el verbo es bajarse, ¿sí? De pronto es porque queda el movimiento así, porque se vuelve un PDF. Como esto era una presentación, pero es más sencillo trabajarlo como PDF, quedan los muñequitos así como mirando para el bus como si se fueran a entrar, pero no. Get off es bajarse, ¿ok? Get off. So the children are getting off the bus. Los niños están bajando del bus, ¿yes? We continue here. This is a question for Sebas. Mrs. Wolf is. Mrs. Wolf is.
Exercising.
Very good. Mrs. Wolf is exercising. Yes, exercising. Now, students, we have to remember these titles. Vamos a recordar estos títulos. Nosotros decimos Miss Daniela, en mi caso Miss Daniela, porque yo no estoy casada, yo no estoy casada, entonces yo digo Miss, para referirme hacia una mujer que no está casada, ¿ok? En el caso de Mrs. Wolf, que lo escribimos MRS, lo vamos a pronunciar Mrs., ¿yes? Entonces tenemos Mrs. Wolf, esto significa que la señora Wolf está casada, ¿sí? Ella está casada. Ahora, para referirme hacia una mujer que yo no sé si está casada o soltera, entonces yo digo Mrs., perdón, Miss. La pronunciación de este y de este título son los mismos. Miss. La escritura es diferente. For example, yo no sé, Rosalba, si está casada o está soltera. Entonces yo digo Miss Rosalba. ¿Yes? Esto en inglés se llaman titles. Titles, que son los títulos. Se utilizan para referirnos a las personas con mucho más respeto, ¿sí? Esto se utiliza mucho al hablarlo, pero se utiliza muchísimo más al momento de escribir cartas, ¿sí? De escribir cartas formales. Para referirme hacia un hombre es muchísimo más sencillo porque utilizo la palabra o el título Mr. Sebastián. Miren qué dice. Mr. Sebastián, ¿yes? Mr. me sirve tanto para un hombre casado como para un hombre soltero. Me sirve para los dos, entonces no hay problema. Mr., ¿yes? Recordemos, Miss, mujer soltera, Mrs. Wolf, mujer casada, Miss Rosalba es una mujer a la cual le estoy demostrando respeto, pero no sé si está casada o está soltera, ¿yes? Students, questions, doubts about this part? Preguntas, dudas acerca de estos títulos?
About the no, title. Teacher, thanks.
Ok. Recuerden estos titles, estos títulos, lo vimos en la primera o en la segunda clase. Yo ya les envié el link como tal de YouTube donde están los videos, ¿sí? Pueden ingresar al link, ahí les va a aparecer todos los videos y al final les aparece el último video. Sí, entonces yo creo que el video de ayer, no, sí, el video de la clase de ayer ya está subido. Entonces simplemente buscamos el mismo link de YouTube y buscamos la última clase que fue la clase número 55, si no estoy mal. Y ahí ya debe estar en YouTube, ¿ok? Entonces para que no nos olvidemos, ahí están los videos por si quieren repasar algún tema. Right? Well, we continue over here. This is a question for Rose. Mr. Black is
Mr. Black is planting the flower.
Well, we can say planting, yes. Podríamos decir planting, yes. Pero este verbo también nos sirve. Watering. Watering es regar. Sí, regar. En este caso la florecita. Yes, watering. Sería más apropiado porque acá tenemos como, ay, se me va el nombre de este utensilio. Es watering, es regar la plantica, watering. Mr. Black is watering the flower. All right, we continue here. Sebas, James is...
James is reading,
yes, writing. Porque si dices reading, entonces estarías diciendo leyendo. Reading, leyendo. Writing, montando, yes. James is riding his horse. All right. Students, how do you say selling in Spanish? You know selling?
Deletreando, ¿no es?
That is spelling. Deletreando, spelling.
Ah,
okay. Sí, son un poquito parecidas. Selling es vendiendo. Selling, vendiendo. All right. We continue here. This is a question. Ah, no, we have already finished this exercise. We continue with this exercise. What is Garfield doing? ¿Qué está haciendo Garfield? What is Garfield doing? Look, Garfield es un gatito, ¿sí? Entonces, yo me puedo referir a él como el pronombre it, ¿sí? O, en este caso, el ejercicio se refiere a Garfield como he, ¿ok? Como he. Pero también, pues hay que saber que también puedo utilizar el pronombre it. En este caso, el ejercicio está como he. ¿Yes? Entonces, vamos a analizar la imagen. Yes, we are going to analyze the image. Y vamos a decir, ¿qué está haciendo Garfield? So, what is Garfield doing? So, we can say, he is eating a watermelon. He's eating a watermelon, yes? Students, how do you say watermelon in Spanish? How do you say that in Spanish? You know, watermelon?
Sandía.
Yes, is this. Sandía, yes. He's eating a watermelon. Okay, so we are going... wait a second. We are going to analyze the image and we are going to answer. He is eating, yes? Now, Sebas, what is Garfield doing? ¿Qué está haciendo Garfield? What is Garfield doing?
Playing.
Playing what?
Basket.
Very good. So, he is playing basketball. He is playing basket. Thank you, Sebas. We continue. Rose, what is Garfield doing?
He is sleeping.
Very good. He is sleeping. Perfect. Sebas, what is Garfield doing?
Watching TV.
Very good. He is watching TV. Now this one, Rose, what is Garfield doing?
He is drinking coffee.
Very good. He is drinking coffee. Yes. Now this one, Sebas, what is Garfield doing?
He is driving.
Very good. He is driving a car. Very good. Now this one, Rose, what is Garfield doing?
He's reading a book.
Very good. He's reading a book. All right, we have finished the exercises about Garfield. Now we are going to continue with this exercise. So look, I'm going to use the red color. No, it's better to use the blue color. Okay, I'm going to put it bigger. Students, do you see? Yes? ¿Alcanzamos a ver las oraciones bien? Yes?
Yeah.
Okay, perfect. Bueno, en el anterior ejercicio habíamos puesto el verbo to be. Sí, habíamos puesto la conjugación del verbo to be. The verb to be. Over here, verb to be conjugated. 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 And verb to be conjugated. En este ejercicio vamos a conjugar el verbo en forma de present continuous, que sería con ing. ¿Yes? Entonces, en paréntesis, we have the verbs, tenemos los verbos. ¿Yes? Vamos a conjugarlos correctamente en el presente continuo. Ahora, yo necesito chequear ustedes cómo están copiando el verbo en su forma de ing, si lo están copiando bien o si de pronto les falta algo o les sobra alguna letra. Entonces, vamos a hacer el siguiente ejercicio. For example, number one, Kate is prepared dinner. la persona que le toque el ejercicio número uno me va a escribir en el chat solo el verbo conjugado, ¿sí? Me va a escribir cómo conjugaría el verbo prepare. En este caso, Kate is preparing. Kate is preparing dinner. Yes. Prepare es un verbo que termina en e, por lo tanto debo eliminar la e y poner ing. ¿Sí? Bueno, ya cuando me hayan escrito la respuesta del verbo solamente, ya procedemos a leer la oración. ¿Ok? Questions, students, questions, doubts.
A teacher, thanks.
Okay, so question number two. This is a question for Rose. They are for Easter eggs. The verb is hunt. Entonces, me vas a copiar en el chat cómo conjugarías hunt. Recordemos que hunt es el verbo cazar, ¿sí? Cazar. Yo estoy acá pendiente en el chat para ver tu respuesta. This is a question for Rose. Hunting, very good. Hunting. So I'm going to write the answer. Hunting, yes. And now, Rose, can you please read number two?
They are hunting for Easter eggs.
Very good. Thank you very much. We continue. Number three, Sebas. The verb is eat. Eat. Yes. Vas a copiar el verbo conjugado en el chat. Eating, very good, perfect. Eating. Now, Sebas, can you please read number three?
We are eating turkey.
Very good, we are eating turkey. Number four, Rose, this is a question for you. The verb is come, come. Coming, perfect, coming. Now, can you please read number four?
The Easter bunny is coming.
Very good. The Easter bunny. El conejito de Pascua está viniendo. Coming significa viniendo. Very good. We continue with Sebas. Number five. The verb is make. Making, perfect. So, making. Sebas, can you please read number five?
I am making Easter eggs.
Very good. I am making Easter eggs. Very good. Number six, Rose, number six. Eating, perfect. Eating. Can you please read number six?
The children are eating candy.
Very good. Students, how do you say candy in Spanish?
Dulces.
Caramelos.
Yes. Dulces o caramelos. Yes, very good. We continue number seven. Sebas. Sing. The verb is sing.
Cantar.
Very good. Now, singing. How do you write that? Please, on the chat. ¿Cómo escribirías el verbo en present continuous? Singing, perfect. Singing. Can you please read number seven?
You are singing a nice song.
Very good. Perfect. Number eight, Rose. The verb is chase. Chase significa cazar. Cazar. Chase. Chasing, perfect. Chasing. Can you read, please, number eight?
The dog is chasing the cat.
Yes, the dog is chasing the cat. Very good. Number nine, Sebas, the verb is run. Pay attention, one syllable verb. That is a one syllable verb. Yes, es un verbo de una sílaba. ¿Cuál es la regla? What is the rule? Running, very good. We double the end. Running.
The perfect. Cat is running.
Very good. The cat is running. Double N. Double N. Double N. And finally, number 10, Rose, please. Drinking. Yes, very good. Wait a second, I'm going to write it here. Drinking. Can you please read number 10?
He is drinking coffee.
Yes, perfect. Very good. All right, students, do you have questions, doubts?
No, teacher, thanks.
Ok. Bueno, chicos, antes de que se me vayan, por acá les voy a dar una información. Recuerden que las membresías de 6 meses y 12 meses se mantienen, ¿sí? Tienen un costo de 240 mil pesos colombianos. Pesos colombianos, la de 6 meses y la de 12 meses, 480 mil pesos colombianos. Se decidió abrir la membresía de un mes, que tiene un costo de 60 mil pesos colombianos. Entonces, para las personitas que tengan alguna duda, alguna inquietud con esta información en cuanto a las membresías, me pueden hablar al interno o le pueden hablar al director de Ciudad Bilingüe para que les pase el número de cuenta o los datos que necesiten, ¿sí? Para que puedan continuar con nosotros. Chicos, recuerden que los videos no se los seguiré enviando al correo, sino que ya están en una lista en YouTube. Es muchísimo más fácil porque están por orden y están por nombre del tema. También tienen la fecha, entonces es mucho más fácil. Si tienen algún inconveniente, alguna duda con los videos, también me lo pueden hacer saber, ¿ok? Students, do you have questions, doubts?
¿Me puedes enviar el número de cuenta para yo mañana o pasado mañana cancelar?
Ah, yes, no problem. Sí, ahorita si quieres me escribes al interno para que me recuerdes y yo ya te mando entonces el número.
Ok. Thank you.
All right, you're welcome. Chicos, les dejo, creo que me faltas tú por firmar. Rose, acá la asistencia. Recuerden que la asistencia se debe firmar todos los días a las clases a las que asistamos. Es un reporte de que ustedes han estado en las clases por si el día de mañana necesitan la certificación, que se pueda corroborar que estuvieron en las clases y obviamente también que tengan el conocimiento, que hayan adquirido el conocimiento durante todos estos meses, ¿ok? Entonces acá les dejo la asistencia, recuerden que es muy importante. En el grupo de WhatsApp también está, por si algún día se les pasa, bueno, podemos firmarla, pero recuerden que la idea es que se firme durante la hora de la clase porque esto, inmediatamente ustedes llenan los datos van a una tabla de Excel. Entonces, si se firma en una hora distinta, va a cambiar un poco, ¿sí? Va a cambiar el orden de la tabla. Entonces, la idea es que todo quede muy organizadito. All right, students, so thank you very much. I'll see you tomorrow. Yes, I'll see you tomorrow at 12 p.m. Take care. Have a nice day.
Thank you, goodbye, teacher. Goodbye.
Goodbye, Sebas. Sí. Yes, Rose, tell me.
Sí, una pregunta. A los 6 meses que se termine el curso, empieza el otro nivel más avanzado, ¿cómo uno pasa del nivel básico al nivel avanzado? ¿Cómo es? No sé, ¿cómo sería?
Por medio de un examen, ¿sí? Presentarías un examen, pero estamos trabajando en ello, entonces no te podría dar la información como tal, pero tienes que presentar el examen para saber si puedes pasar al siguiente nivel.
Ah, ok. ¿Y cada nivel dura cuánto?
Pues esto depende mucho de las personas, ¿sí? Se diría que en 6 meses, pues yo hablando desde mi experiencia, si tú estudias juiciosa, en 6 meses puedes adquirir un nivel A1, en otros 6 meses puedes adquirir un nivel A2 y así sucesivamente. O sea, un mínimo de 6 meses para que se vea un cambio significativo, por decirlo así. Yo diría en 6 meses, si estudias juiciosa, lo bueno es que nosotros vemos clase todos los días, entonces estamos recordando cada vez más el idioma, lo estamos mecanizando, todo ya se vuelve más natural, por decirlo así. Entonces, La temática nos ayuda demasiado, ¿sí? Como las horas de la clase. Para que pases un nivel, sí, tienes que presentar el examen y pues un nivel realmente se adquiere con un mínimo de 4 o 5 meses de estudio.
Ok.
All right.
Okay. Bueno, pues, so, thank you.
You're welcome. I'll see you tomorrow. Take care.
Tomorrow.